Story time!
Is this... Is this the BTS concert?
Ah! Do tell!
He looked at all of us like one by one and he was just like... Sorry.
Not sorry! Own it! People, this is history happening in front of our eyes!
Successful fan, successful army.
She walked so we could run.
Hi guys! Welcome back to the channel of the BTS Dream Girls! Well, that's what we call it ourselves.
That's like, nice though!
Okay, we're the BTS Dream Girls. Yeah. Pretty much, darling.
For those of you who don't know what's going on,
if you don't know, just
that happened.
Yeah, so that happened. So somebody out here was participating at the Permission to Dance on stage in Seoul.
The first concert in life, like
in 2 years,
person in 2 years, she was there.
I was
and
there.
She wasn't there in the public. She was there.
I was. Not at the concert, I was in the concert.
Oh!
We're just gonna do small story time.
And to be honest, I specifically asked her not to tell me much of it because I want to hear it.
She did! I need to have a real reaction!
I want to be blown away.
How
exactly did you get this opportunity?
Oh, okay, so we get a lot of questions like this.
You know, where are the questions? We have all the questions.
Oh yeah, so some of you ask questions on our Instagram. We will just do the Q&A at the end. I'll just talk about like the process of everything. And at the end, we'll check the question if we didn't answer already.
Okay. Let's go. Anyway, how did you get this amazing opportunity?
Okay, so that's gonna like be so crazy because it was so easy. Like, it was so random.
It was, yeah.
So basically, some of you might know, but my current job full time is a model in Korea, right? So I usually do commercials, dramas as an extra, etc., whatever. And so when you're a model, you do have an agency. So I have my home agency, which is Anyas Entertainment, but you also can work as a freelancer. So basically I sent my profile to like literally at this point like hundreds of agencies probably have my information because I've been doing it for a long time. If they have a casting, they will contact you.
I remember it was from, we were in Gangneung. I was just reading about the news about the concert.
Oh!
They were just like, I was telling you, oh, they have the concert on, like, they just announced it on Weverse, like, blah, blah, blah. It's that date,
Yes!
And then she gets a text. Are you free?
Random, they're like, are you free on the March 8, 9, 10, 12, and 13?
For
like,
a concert for a boys band.
They said for a famous boys band. Because I'm like, okay, it could be anybody. And then they said famous. I was like,
Bridget, this looks very similar to what I just read.
I'm like, this sounds familiar. So I'm like, yeah, I'm available. Why? And they're like, oh, the artist is confidential. So I'm like, is this the BTS concert? So that's basically how it is. They just contact you on either Instagram, Kakao, whatever. If they have your number, they call you and they're like, are you free? If you are, that's it. They tell you exactly everything.
My question is, by the time they contact you, did they already make their mind about like they want you?
No.
Or is it like a casting?
Usually it's just casting. When the agencies call you, it means that they're listing you up. They always call it like a list up in Korean.
Okay.
And so they just send your profile to the client. So basically they will send our profile to Hive and Hive picks who they want. That's
so you got selected by Hive.
I got selected by Hive. That's pretty much what happened. Next question! Somebody asked if it was BTS or HYBE's idea to have an all-black cast. I know a lot of people mentioned this also on Twitter. Basically, I think, we don't know for sure, but I think what they wanted to recreate was the whole atmosphere of like the American Life band with the, you know, with the girls in the background.
Originally, old school,
it was usually black women. So I think they just wanted to recreate that kind of like concept because they did the butter in like kind of like a old school.
Yeah.
Old school sounds, so I think that's all. That's, I don't think they're like, we want black women.
I appreciate
the representation.
Yeah, exactly.
We really appreciated it. It was really nice.
It's not the first time too that they did that.
Yeah, it's not the first time.
2 years ago, before COVID. Yeah. they had like a mix of different
and this is what I like about them, like they've had a different diverse background in a while, long time. So I didn't think I'm like the token black girl. I just felt like, oh, this is a concept and we fit the concept that they picked us. So that was pretty awesome.
It's nice. Then what happened?
After it was really simple, they created just like a group chat for everybody that was in the concert. And I'm like, okay, we're gonna have a meeting. So we had one meeting, two rehearsals, and then the concert. So basically we just met and they explained to us what we're gonna do.
What about the clothing though?
Yo, so they told this to us like the second at the rehearsal, because we had to do a dress rehearsal. I'll come to that, because that's a juicy part. So anyway, that was it. That was for the process, and then the next day literally was dress rehearsal. So the first day was without BTS, and then the next day was with BTS coming. So
in the stadium.
Yeah, at the stadium. That's where we saw the boys for the first time, like in real life. Let me tell you. Like, I don't even know
how to... Detail!
I don't even know how to express this shit, because first of all, when you have a concert, obviously we're dancers, right? So we had to stay backstage the whole time. I wanted to watch the concert because also I'm an army. So if you're in an army, it's even harder because you want to be professional, but I wanted to watch the show. But my luck, the day of the rehearsal, they had to do the whole concert from like soundcheck to everything, dressed up and everything. And so I was just like, no one is in the stadium except like Big Hit and us. Can we just go watch it? And the manager was like, yeah, I guess. So like me and another girl, because the other one were like, oh no, yeah, we're just gonna rest. I was like, okay, cool. And so we went out, we went inside in the audience. We thought they were gonna be like, no, you gotta go. Nothing. We watched the entire concert.
Oh really?
We were the only ones with the staff, and we were sitting. And we're like, there's no way. When BTS comes, they're gonna like tell us to leave. No, we were there, and like BTS just comes out, like, and you can't scream because obviously you have to like do your job and not be like the fan, the crazy fan. No. So literally, I was the only one. I got up because I was like, no, I can't be sitting like this.
Ah,
I got up. I was dancing. They did Fire. They did all the songs. Like, they did from the beginning to the end, and I was just like, yeah. And then at some point, you know how there's like the moment where they get in the like the big cabbie and they. Like
around the stadium.
We were, you know, when they roll in, we were right there, like on the way. Like, okay, this is my moment. No, not really. But I was just like, no, I'm gonna enjoy this. Because at first I was like, I'm too scared to like look. But I was just like, this is my only chance.
Yeah.
Literally. So literally, we had our shoes, but they're like heels, so they hurt. So I had in my hands, and my shoes are really like shiny, like pantak. So I was just like going like this with my shoes, and then literally. So fucking embarrassing. Literally, RM. So there was RM, Jin, and I don't remember who else was on the thing because it was separated by two. So they were just walking, and I was just like this with my shoes. And Jin looked at me, and he was like, "Oh my
god, success!
He's even cuter in real life. How do you look
success!
Like a baby?
No.
And we're the same age. When that happened, all the members, not the members, not BTS members, the crew, the other dancers, they looked at me like, are you okay? And I was like, yes.
The cheer.
Because they knew, because they were like, Bridget, are you going to be okay? So I was like, I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't know if I'm going to control myself. And they were like, and there's this one guy who played the guitar. I had to hold his arm really tightly. I was like, tidy. And he was like, whoa, are you okay? I was like, just hold me. Just keep
otherwise
me.
Otherwise, I'm going to fall.
Otherwise, I'm going to pass out. So yeah, anyway, so that's the moment where I made the most eye contact, because that was like, nobody was there. So I made eye contact with RM and Jin the most. And so Jungkook was just like partying.
We can thank the shoes.
Oh yeah, we can thank the shoes, because I was like, my shoes are shiny. You're gonna see me.
You're gonna see me today.
I was like,
see me
once in a lifetime. I will never forget it. I have the image printed in my brain.
The concert, the D-Day.
The concert was like, it was crazy, because like, it was obviously my favorite part. So before, because it was just them, so that was so cool, because we could just see them like just like regular people. It went by so fast. Like, we just basically. Where you know how like you have the backstage area, there's like stairs, so we would just go up the stairs, and we were already on the platform where when BTS was doing Life Goes On. So that was pretty cool, because we got to just watch from behind. So we could see like all the army. It was so pretty. It was like purple ocean, blue ocean. So nice. So we were just kind of hanging out. We had our mics and we were just ready. It was so cold. We were just like so we waited, and they did Boy With Love, and then I did the selfie. So we got to watch like all those songs like three times, so that was pretty cool. And right when they started like talking, they did their little speech, we got ready, and we were just like dun, dun, and that's pretty much it. The concert part goes really fast because you know we were just dancing.
It's like two songs.
It was two songs. Mm-hmm. So at the last day we had to take pictures with the dancers, so I'll put them right here. But got to take a picture with the dancers, with BTS's stylist, so she took like a picture of all of it. I kind of want to find her on Instagram because I want to see that picture. That was really a really really fun experience.
Yeah,
I don't think I'll ever forget.
I don't think so either.
I really don't.
I won't forget. So
yeah, like it was because I was texting her every moment. I was like, this is just happening. My friend just walked past me. She's like, oh my god, screaming in the distance. That was pretty much it, really.
Wait, it's not it. Juicy details, girl.
What juicy details? Okay, let's see the questions and I'll reply in the question. And if I haven't already, I'll reply. If I have, I'll just skip the question.
So we answered about how she got the gig. Yeah. How was all the preparation? Yeah. Was it scary up there?
Oh.
Was it high?
It was like roughly 8 to 10 meters. And we were on hills.
Hey.
So if you go to, like, we were at a safe, because there was, the security was all around, like, just checking us out. But we stayed at a safe distance, but yeah, that could have been pretty painful if you fell from there.
Were you cold?
It was very cold. So we were dancing backstage just to try to, like, stay really warm. So yeah.
Mm-hmm. How are they in real life? Like, physically?
Okay, no surprise there. They look exactly the same as their V-Live, I would say. Because, like, we saw them without makeup and then with makeup. So, obviously, you see them in their music video. They look the same when they have makeup on. And when they don't have any makeup on, they just look like when they're in the V-Live. So, there is no surprise. But what I was really shocked about is how tall they were.
Around 80. 180.
Right? 180, I wouldn't say so.
No, 80 is RM.
Jimmy, yeah. Okay, so the most impressive one, the most impressive ones were RM and Jin. They were really tall.
What about Jungkook?
Jungkook looks good. Jungkook. No, but it's true.
The way you sound, like,
no, he looks so good. Like,
I mean, Jungkook, I'm calling Jungkook.
No, but seriously, what shocked me the most about Jungkook is like he, you know, we see him in like pictures, even his stories or anything, but in real life, he looks like a baby.
Oh, really?
He had, like, it's a baby face over a masculine body, and I like, don't understand. Like,
what's going on?
But, like, if you see him, he didn't have any makeup the first day rehearsal, and we were looking at him, it's like, whoa, he looks like a baby.
Really?
Like, he looks his age, for real. And I didn't think so in pictures, but he looks like his face is much smaller and, like, chubby.
Like, he looks older with makeup now. Like, with
he
makeup and
looks
the,
older with makeup, but with no
hairstyle.
Makeup, a baby.
I think the hairstyle helps a lot.
He was so cute. He was so adorable. Aww. And Jimin too. Jimin was so cute.
Aww.
I mean, I've seen them before, so I wasn't surprised, but I was still shook. I was like, whoa, wow, y'all are really that cute in real life. Oh my god. And then.
So RM is impressive. Like,
RM is the most impressive. He's like, bam, bam.
I mean, it's because he's supposed to be going to the gym or something.
Yeah,
so, like, he built like, bam.
He's like, really, like, he's also like tall. When they were getting ready, he was the one that you could see from like very far away. Like, he was always the one you see first, and he had blonde hair. So
yeah, it was a whole thing.
Yeah. J-Hope, I don't know, he wasn't really different. He really looked the same. I wasn't surprised by J-Hope.
Yeah, I don't think he's doing much.
Yeah. He has really good skin though, I could say that. Yeah, I was like,
Suga! Well, okay, because I saw that on the story when you said that this man is art in real life, and I'm like, please do say more.
I don't know. He just looks really good.
He looks good, yeah.
He's becoming, I think he's becoming more handsome now, because really, I was just like, wow.
Okay. Did that happen?
It was so funny because, again, they're the same as we know them. Suga was like the tired one.
Yeah.
He was just like, I want to do this. Like, especially during the rehearsal, he was supposed to do his like speech and he was just like, la 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 la. Yeah, and we were all like cracking up, like the staff and us were all laughing. Because they all did, yeah, 안녕하세요, 비입니다. And then Suga was like, blah 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 blah.
Nah,
okay.
I
was like, okay, I guess you want it to be over.
Character of the Jin, also impressive, yeah? He said like
Jin was so cute. He was so cute. He was really tall and he was so cute. Like him and Jungkook baby faces. Yeah. Like for real. With no makeup, baby faces like adorable.
Oh.
I hesitated to talk about this because I don't want ARMY to actually... I'm an ARMY too! Don't kill me! Like, I don't want people to like kill me, but literally we were talking about this because V is the one who checks us out the most. V came in, yeah, and mind you, I'm the first in his visual... Because he was like, let's say I'm here, the stage is here and the seats are over there. He came in from here. They all came in like this, so he was the last one and I was the last one of the girl. So he came in at the same time. And then he just like... Because we were wearing our dresses and everything. So he was just like, looked at us, and I was just like, oh my god, look away, look away. Look away, look away.
I'm normal.
I was like, don't look at him, because I didn't want, okay, this is what I didn't want. I didn't want the staff to think that I was trying to smile at him and be like, oh, hello. So I was just like, okay, let's just keep it professional and look around, like over there. But he kept looking, and then he looked at all of us like one by one. He was just like, oh, they're pretty or whatever. I mean, we look good.
Man, it is what it is. The man has taste.
We did it for the sisters. And then he went to the center of the stage, and everybody else was just looking at the audience, and he was the only one turned around. He was the only one like this.
My man.
I was like,
my man, okay. 실제로 방탄 멤버들을 본 기분이 어때요?
꿈 같았어요. Anyways. Next.
Oh, there's a question about how we're here, like how you in Korea and how you managed to become a model. We already did a video about that, several videos, but there's one like summarizing all of this, so you can check that out over there. Congratulations. Congratulations.
I got really a lot of message from fellow armies on Twitter and on Instagram, so thank you very much. And on YouTube too, in our shorts. So,
is my bias V really, really handsome in real life?
Yeah.
Yeah,
there is no question about it. V is like, and it's so funny because they hadn't shaved during the rehearsal, so they all looked more like natural, you know. I like that better than I like the makeup too, yeah. But it was so funny to see RM with the beard.
But like 3 days beard.
Like right? 3 days beard, like very, very small, but it was so funny. I was like, ah man, they look good in any capacity. And like they're like so nice, like they were nice to everybody, they're really polite. Like everybody knows that already, so I'm here to confirm. They're the so cute. So cute. So anywho, that's pretty much
it all.
Yeah, I think that's pretty much all I have. Like
she's gonna be on cloud nine for a little bit, like some years, I think so.
My boyfriend was like, are you gonna leave me? I was like, I'm not gonna leave you, but if RM comes talk to me. No, I still choose my boyfriend over BTS.
That's love. I think there's not better than this. Nothing better than this. Anyway, what was your best moment then of the whole thing?
I don't care. My best moment was seeing RM. I don't care.
It
was fun and all, but like RM, like I have two biases and I love them all, like OT7 for life, but Jimin and RM are like my babies. Mm-hmm. And so I made eye contact with RM more than everybody else. V too, but RM most often because I was in the same hall that they were. For some reason. And yeah, RM was adorable. The second best moment in my experience is that the first day of the concert, I was hanging out in the hall because there's like no data in backstage. So our room, dancer's room, is here. There was a big hall with the stairs to go up on the stage, and then their room is right here. So we could hear everything. These kids are loud. They're like, blah, 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 blah. I'm like, and I could recognize all of their voices. So I'm like, oh my god, girl, if you don't stop talking right now. Because at some point, you forget it's BTS. You're just like, person to person, you're being loud. I'm trying to be on my phone. So at some point, I'm looking away. And I'm on my phone and I was texting you. I was texting you in that moment. And I hear, ha! The way I jumped. And you know what? I made a mistake because I was like, oh. Like looking so annoyed. Guess who it was? It was Jin.
Stupid.
And literally, I turn around like this, and RM is like, and I'm like, I'm so sorry. I have nothing to say. I'm sorry, it's fine. Scream as you want. Scream, please scream. This is the thing, there is nobody else except for them, the security, and me. I was alone because the girls are in the room, so I was just chilling on my phone. So they totally saw me go like, so I was like, I'm so sorry, I didn't know it was you. And I wanted to be like, I love you so much, but I was just like, I can't talk to them because that would be kind of unprofessional, right? So I was just like this, and I was just observing, and they were so cute. And so after they went for, I think it was sound check at that moment, and like RM was like jumping like, oh, Kaza! So like, I was like, okay. And then he went back, and then at some point I was just like still just hanging out on my phone because I didn't have any Wi-Fi in the room, so I kept going like this. And I just felt wind in my back, like, and I turn around and RM is just like, ah, going back to his room, and I'm like, did he just walk past me and I missed it?
Ugh, what am I doing with my life?
Anyway, that was it for the story time. See you guys later.
Bye.